Hey guys, so in this edition of Kids Say the Darnest Things, and I feel like I have so many of those to share, those kind of stories, but this story is really, I'm working, I have a student that I'm doing one-on-one counseling with, and I'm not, for confidentiality reasons, of course, I can't reveal anything, I can't really say too much of anything, but I will say, she said this at one point, and it was so, like, I was just like, wow, that's such a powerful statement that you said. You know, it was like that moment, it's like, kids say the darndest thing, and you just said one of the most amazing things ever. And it was kind of eye-opening. I told this to my supervisor, and or she read the process recording of the conversation, and I guess she didn't have as deep reaction as I did. It really resonated with me. What she said, but what she said is also not very helpful. Anyway, the student was pretty much saying that the school is a place you come to be judged, and that's why, like, coming to school is such a challenge, or being in school is such a challenge. Everybody is judging you. That's pretty much what she said. I can't say verbatim what she said, but that was kind of the core message of the student statement, and I was just like, holy crap, like, how do you argue against that? You know, the school is a place to be judged. Seriously, it is. You're graded on your performance on everything, homework, test, and how you interact with others, also viewed by staff members, by peers. There's bullying in school based on how you dressed, based on your who you are, really. If you're perceived as anything different in school, especially in a high school setting, then you're picked on, then you're ostracized, you're isolated, you know, your friends treat you differently, or people treat you differently. And there's so much things in especially in high school, where so much about yourself, if you're perceived as different, that leaves you vulnerable, and that leaves you judged and negatively treated. So it was a powerful statement, you know, the school is a place to be judged. All eyes in school are judging. And it's just like, wow, like how, like what a profound statement in a lot of ways. But it's, school is a place where you have to overcome that challenge. But it's also, society kind of expects everyone to rise above that challenge, you know. When we look at measure of success of, you know, community and school, we tend to kind of focus on, like, the graduation rate, you know. How many kids graduated high school, you know, what percentage of kids? Oh, those kids are graduated high school, so that's good. We're starting to have a conversation now about the value of college, which I think is a good, needed conversation. But at the same time, that conversation can be dangerous in the sense when the result is kids don't need college anymore. They should just get, you know, high school and go straight to work right away. For some kids, I think that's a good path. You know, go to vocational schools or get into vocational training. That's great. I think that this is a needed conversation. But this is a society where more and more, you know, value of college education is becoming less and less. But that doesn't mean the expectations of people hiring are any less. You know, a college graduate may get a job as a janitor. That doesn't mean that a person without a college diploma is just as likely to get the janitor position. It just means the competition is that much crazier now, right? So a high school dropout, what happens to them? That's actually something that I want to focus on later in my social work research project. But yeah, it's a place to be judged, and you're constantly judged about anything and everything. It's why a student like her is afraid to raise her hand in class and speak in class and participate in classroom activities. Because anything you do can be perceived one way or the other, even though the truth of the matter is it might be this or it might be that. I was reading this book, and I'll make a video about my thoughts of this book, and I'll pull some quotes out of the book. But it's a fiction. It's a fictional book written by Rainbow Doel, I think. I forgot the author's name, but I know the first name is Rainbow. The book's name is Eleanor and Park. And I thought it was an extremely powerful book because it kind of details this kid, Eleanor, this white girl who's rather big in size with freckles and red hair, living in poverty. You know, she has extremely weird clothing choices because that's the only clothes she has. Because they can't, the family can't afford clothes that fit her or that look nice. And how she is judged in this new school that she goes to is quite, it's a very kind of, heartwarming tale. Like, the book is extremely powerful that kind of demonstrate where bullying can go. And nowadays, so I think the book is set in the 90s or the 80s, and somewhere in that time period. But now, bullying is more serious now, because it's beyond bullying. There's also now cyberbullying. You know, kids can get on the Facebook and just harass someone on Facebook. It's easier to deal with on paper. You know, you can just ignore it. You know, never, don't log on, don't comment back. But it's a type of bullying that follows you home. You can go home, log on to the internet, and you're being bullied in your own home. Bullying in school, it was just kind of, it stayed in school, you know, or maybe after school, like in some kind of physical realm. But cyberbullying, you know, imagine, it's midnight, you can't go to sleep, you log online to do your homework or whatever, and you get on Facebook to chat with your friend, and it's happening right there at home at midnight. And I think that's a crazy serious issue. So the judgment that you feel at school is continuing on to and following you to your own home. And so the statement that a school is a place you go to be judged, there's a continuation of that. Not only that, but the judgment that you receive at school can follow you to your own home. And I think that's something that teenagers and schools and adolescents and, you know, elementary school kids really have to deal with. Not a lot of kids view it that way, you know. And teachers and social workers and school psychologists can overlook this, you know, saying like, okay, well, what makes her come to that conclusion, or what makes the student think that she's being judged? What can we fix for that? When actually the perspective we might need to have is that student is perfectly legitimate and valid in having that viewpoint. It's not whether we should convince her or to persuade her that she's wrong, that school is not a place to be judged. But it really is, okay, well then, how can we help you cope with this? You know, how can we maybe even change the system? Although that's hard. It's really hard to set school systems and city system and state systems and country policies and laws. But if somehow, you know, any changes that could be made to accommodate the fears, the judgment that the school kids face, that would be powerful, I think. And that's why, like, when I had that session with the student and she said something like this, I was just, like, I was just left speechless. I was like, you just said the most, like, profound statement that I've really heard from, like, a 14-year-old, you know. And 14-year-olds say a lot of profound things. I really have to kind of put it out there. Do not underestimate the talent and the brain power and the line of thinking of adolescents, of teenagers. Their brains are underdeveloped, but that doesn't mean that they are quite amazing individuals. So I'll leave it at that. Cheers.